Hey everybody, our first project this week is a portraiture project focusing on either your face, a sibling's face, it can even be somebody famous, that's totally fine. What we're focusing on this week is light and shadow using textures. Textures is a term from last week's projects, one of the choices that some of you guys did. And you're not actually going to be drawing our face, but you are going to be forming the face using and observing the shadows in a picture that you choose. And I'm going to demonstrate how to do this inside of Sketches Pro. We've done light and shadow in class before. We've gone over shading techniques, and a lot of these techniques are built right into Sketches Pro. The basic principle that we've gone over is how to create 3D forms using different shading techniques. I'm doing the exact same thing here by really just using the texture tool on the left-hand side and overlapping textures that I choose to create those values. And although I'm using just black and white for this portrait, you can use any colors that you want. Start first by finding a photo of somebody that has a good range of both darks and lights. If the picture is too dark or too light, it's either going to be really, really easy and there's not going to be enough value to recreate, or it's going to be too dark and you're going to have way too many layers for it to be understandable. This is a picture of my daughter Kira that I found. A decent amount of lights and darks. It's expressive, and I think it's going to be good for this project. Your layer organization is going to be important. You want to make sure that your photograph is on one layer, you have it locked, like I have mine down here, and then a second layer on top, which is your artwork layer. And the only tool that I'm using right now is the texture tool that's highlighted on the left-hand side. I'm starting my project by selecting a texture from the options. It's kind of like a mid-range diagonal hatching texture that's going to work well for my base layers first. I'm going to start by tracing the entire form of my face, or my daughter's face, including the shoulders. You're going to see that dotted line. That's the path of my pen or my finger that I'm using. I'm not really focusing on the little wispy hairs, but just kind of the main form of the head. You can start anywhere. I'm starting with the eyebrows here. Just outlining the basic shape of the eyebrows and the eyebrow shadow. I'm also overlapping the shapes to try to start to mold out the shape and the depth of the forehead. Any kind of really fine lines like around the eyes, the eyelids, things that are around the mouth, any wrinkles, you can outline those and circle them really, really finely to get that detail. With the nose and the mouth, I'm just doing the darkest areas first, and that gives me a pretty good frame to keep working on. At this point, I'm not really focused on getting the darkest darks, but I'm just trying to get the basic form of all these finer details inside of my daughter's mouth. I'm only a few minutes into the project, and I'm just doing a quick progress check on hiding my photo on the photo layer. And I can already kind of tell that it is my daughter. I think it's pretty successful, and you see where the different textures are overlapping. You can use the same texture for the entire project. In order to get those darker areas though, you might want to find some textures that overlap or contrast with the other textures. I'm going to try this dot pattern for some of the larger areas, like in the hair or in the eyes, and I'm going to see what that does. You can also adjust your patterns with the sliders on the right hand side. After I get most of the mid-range tones, like the medium grays, I'm going to start focusing on the darker areas that really help mold out the face. tell me what to want. With the eyes in the darkest areas, you're going to want to overlap those textures a few times and even change up the textures as well. After only about 10 minutes of work, I got a pretty good portrait and I'm really happy with the way it's turning out. What you might find after working on this for just a few minutes is that you're going to start to notice shadows that you may have not seen when you first opened the picture. So here I'm just choosing a really, really light shade of black here and going over some of those lighter, harder to see shadows just to help mold out the face. Drawing noses is probably one of the hardest things to do for students. In this project, just using the tones and the shadows, you're going to see that you can do these same techniques just using a pencil to correctly form the bridge of the nose. Up top, like I said, we don't really want to focus on those individual hairs, so I'm just going to replicate the general tone that those shadows, that those hairs make on top of the skin. I check back and forth frequently to make sure that my project's going the way that I want. It won't help to do everything at once and then check at the end, because you might make a mistake that you can't undo. My next step is finding a background that complements my drawing. Kira's personality is pretty fun. She loves sparkles, she loves the colors pink and purple, and I'm gonna try to find something that matches. My layer order is now one empty layer beneath my drawing. It's between my photo and my artwork layer. I just did a quick Google search, made sure it was a large image, and I'm gonna drop that, I'm gonna rotate it, and make sure it takes up my entire space so there's no white space available. On the right, you'll see my layer order that lets me edit each layer individually. Here I'm using the eraser tool to mask out the drawing that I created. It's kind of cool, it can create some cool effects, and you're totally welcome to play around with the different kind of artwork you can make using this technique. I'm changing the size of my tool to make sure that I come right to the edge of my artwork. I have a little bit of overlap, that's okay. At this point, I'm going to start focusing on some of those finer hairs up there. I'm not really being too exact. I just want to show the sense of the hair. I'm going to use my water brush to create some of those wispier hairs with a really fine point. My last step in the artwork phase is to add some white on top of my artwork layer to add some of those highlights in the eyes, some of the teeth, and that really brings out the highlights and sends some of those darker areas back. Last step is saving an image for Schoology upload. In the three dots up top, tap those, hit the upload button, click save image, and that image is ready to submit.